Yeah, but no, you can't show that because
I'm not showing. I don't show money.
They gonna think that. I don't show. That's how Drake on niggas living. Niggas is only getting like 20, 46. No, I'm living really, really nice now. Okay, look at these custom made shoes.
Those are mine.
These are from Sir.
British Knight.
Oh. Yeah, and Sir. I guess it connects with them now, you know what I'm saying? And it's definitely something a lot of people going through, so they feel it. And that's why I feel like it's taking a life form that it's taking. Because I feel like if nobody's really into it, they wouldn't, you know, be doing it like that, switching it up. And, like, I hear everything.
It's the universal record that when they hear it. Like, one thing about American music to people outside of America, it brings them so much joy to hear it. You just see it. You don't try to mimic the videos. Whatever you did in the videos, what they do in the show. To me, that's a fly shit. So how big is that record right now?
Pretty big. It won gold. Got nominated for a Grammy. So, I mean, coming from where
Drake got on it.
Yeah, Drake got on it. Like, it's huge.
He's saying, like, you can... So you got that nigga there saying that nigga went high note on Drake. That nigga you struck a nerve when he heard that. Said, who was that nigga singing that? Hold on. Give me a copy.
I was crazy. I was like, damn, Drake singing my shit? Like, he listened, that's crazy.
You see what I'm saying, right? Yeah. See, I know that's the first thing he was like, this nigga, that nigga know my shit.
Yeah.
Like, them notes that you hit is inspiring to a nigga that write and sing.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
That was just the greatest of.
When you wrote that song, was it like freelancing, or was it like, I'm really gonna come up with a song, I really wanna focus on, was it just like a regular song?
It was just freestyle, for real. Like, we was in the studio. I first made it in July of 2013, like the first part I recorded of it. And I was in the studio with some producers, and we were just vibing out. And then it was like Monday night, and then I was turning in on Tuesday morning. And, you know, I was just thinking about, you know, my whole little life I was doing. I was off. Like, I had to work and all that. And so I was just like, you know, got the club going up, you know what I'm saying, on Tuesday. And I was really thinking in the whole sense of, you know, we're in the house, and we out here having fun, and it's going up. But I'm like, where are people going to be at? You know what I'm saying? And so I was like, you know, the club, and that's where we'll be at. And so it's like, the club going up on Tuesday, and I just freestyled. I was like working Monday night on the corner flipping hard, man, at least 3,000 on the boulevard, like working graveyard.
At least 3,000? Hey, listen to what you said, though. Yeah, because see, words is the way you make a move. Well, you make the motherfucking words move. It's like, it was a nigga named Mixmaster Spade. And they used to get in the 80s, and he used to get in.
Rest in peace.
It's just a huge accomplishment. I used to, I'm up like on West 21st Street in LA, like over there in Adams and all that. So like, we used to watch the Grammys and like all the award shows, and be right down the street at the Shrine, like the Staples Center and all that. So it's like, I never thought I would be up for a Grammy, you know what I'm saying? Like, I never made music with that intention or anything. I just wanted to, you know what I'm saying, connect with people and just give them something that they could feel. And then I guess that's what the Grammys was feeling. I was like, wow, that's crazy. Like, I don't. It's like certain people, I know they make things to try to get on these people's radar, but I wasn't really making it for those people's radar. I was just fat nerd.
Favorite pair of shoes of all time?
I don't think I've seen them yet.
Your favorite pair of shoes ain't came out yet?
Yeah, I mean, I guess too many. I mean, I don't know. I like.
The nigga, like, I like shoes. Nigga, like, I don't like one pair.
Yeah, it's hard to pick a pair.
Taraji P. Henson or Kerry Washington?
Washington is.
She's damn near 100 on my motherfucking show. We're gonna have to find another bitch like
this. She fucking Gary up.
You know what I'm saying? We're gonna have to find somebody that she's that can stand up to her.
Yeah.
Maybe that's a porno star, somebody nasty and slutty, I'm sure.
Okay, I'll take the slut.
Nobody y'all know this is crazy, man. Black or white?
Black.
Favorite drink?
Water.
Favorite sports team?
Lakers.
Weekends or weekday?
Weekends.
Ass or titty?
Ass.
Chevrolet or Cadillac?
Cadillac.
How many times a day do you think about sex?
I think over 50.
This nigga's a sex fiend. And that's the last one he's supposed to be. If you could have a superpower, what would it be?
To teleport.
Teleport what?
Myself. Like, just disappear here and be in New York right now.
Okay, so the homie said that earlier, he said, but to teleport on the home. You say whatever the bitch get to talking too much shit to get disappeared from the bitch. It'd be in conversation.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a part of it. You can
use it
during that.
Okay. If I could work with anybody dead or alive, I could work with
them.
If I could see anybody born dead or alive, I could work with them.
Prince.
I look for blank in a woman.
Independence.
If I wasn't the boss, I'd be. My favorite position is
owner.
My name is McConan and I'm
he.
And you do know that, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we'd like to thank you for tuning in to the motherfucking GGN Rules Network. It's what we do with the most undercoats as opposed to the boogie. I'm your host with the most, fine Nemo, aka Nemo Host. I want to thank my guests for coming down representing on a Tuesday. Doing what he does the real motherfucking way. His new name is Tuesday. But I want y'all to call you. I'll call you Tuesday when y'all have seen you. But let them know where they can catch you at or where they can hit you up at if they're trying to get in touch with you.
Hit me up on Twitter. I love McConan5D. Hit me up on Instagram. I love McConan. Hit me up on iTunes. I love McConan.
You didn't get that, man. Real talk, real spirit, real fast. That EP will be out when?
Today.
On Saturday?
Yes.
I'll go get it, man. Good plan, man. What you waiting on? Hit the download button, you're gonna get that.
And retweet that Swerve link and send it to me. And let me know what that shit sounds like.
So fast. Peace, love, and soul.
That's SDB. Yo, this is I Love McConan, and you're watching GGN on West Fest TV.
Damn. That didn't tell you. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
What's in your way?
Thank you.
All the time, nephew. Always a pleasant treat. Let me know when that thing.